Good afternoon, fellow Benedictines, brothers and sisters in Christ. This Mass is being offered for the following intentions: thanksgiving for all the graces and blessings received, for good health, for the gift of life, petitions for peace and harmony in our workplace, in our country, and in the world, for the success of our online teaching and learning activities, for safety and protection against COVID-19 of the SBCEC administration, faculty and staff, parents and students, for healing of those who are sick, especially the members of the SBCEC community, for complete healing and recovery of Aris Emmanuel, Concepcion, and Isidro, for the safety of Stephanie, Cristeta, Rodolfo, Romel, Nympha Claire, and Kenneth Lau, for the eternal repose of the souls of Ms. Lydia C. Banias, Attorney Francis M. Zosa, Tita Norma, Tita Mila, Tita Christy, Tita Linda, Tito Edwin, Manong Joel, Tito Ray, Zarina Barrios, Wyatt Earl Barrios, Consorcio, Victor, Wilwell, William Ballesteros, Pedrita Maricho Salome, Presca Omega on her death anniversary, Jovito Yolohio, Teofilo Eliseo, Irenia, Gregorio Agapita, Alexander, Aristotle Sr., Yunita Dulcisima Bargamento on her death anniversary, Paterno Dennis Alo, Arturo Domino Nestor Vicente, Estrella Josefina, Mariano, and Geoffrey. When you are hungry, you need food. This food can be relatively good or relatively lacking. But as long as you have your fill, that unpleasant feeling of being hungry will no longer be there. It will be gone. You can sit there and your body will be at rest. What comes from God, what He has and is, and His everything are greater than anything, including the thing or the person you once believed or treasured the most. That is to say, if a person can have the words of the mouth of God, or they didn't understand His will, they can gain in peace. Everything God does is truth and life.
Mother's Day. At the same time, we also celebrate today the feast of Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta, who was still alive for some of us. She was called as a living saint. And of course, we ask the intercession of Saint Aloysius, since it's your class patron, and all the saints, especially Saint Teresa, for all our intentions. Coming together as God's family, let us now acknowledge our sins to make ourselves less unworthy to celebrate this Holy Eucharist. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
And you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May our Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have taught your church to keep all the heavenly commandments by love of you as God and love of neighbor, grant that practicing the works of charity after the example of Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta, we may be worthy to be numbered among the blessed in your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let's now listen to the readings.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. God has put us apostles at the end of the line, like men doomed to die in the arena. We have become a spectacle to the universe, to angels and men alike. We are fools on Christ's account. But in Christ, you are wise. We are the weak ones, you the strong. They honor you while they sneer at us. Up to this very hour, we go hungry and thirsty, poorly clad, roughly treated, wandering about homeless. We work hard at manual labor. When we are insulted, we respond with a blessing. Persecution comes our way. We bear it patiently. We are slandered and we try conciliation. We have become the world's refuse, the scum of all. That is the present state of affairs. I am writing you in this way, not to shame you, but to admonish you as my beloved children. Granted, you have 10,000 guardians in Christ, you have only one Father. It was I who begot you in Christ Jesus through my preaching of the gospel. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord is just in all his ways.
Of course, this is not to look down on other religious congregations, especially the sisters. But for me, based on what I have seen and I have observed, because I'm saying Mass with them both here in Cebu and in Manila, they are the religious congregation who really concretely practice works of charity. Because you know what? From the children and to the aged, the abandoned children, they also have this, their own center. Much more, the abandoned aged, ito mga gibiyaan ng mga bata, that may pakay gibiyas karsada, o katong mga lola, lolo na ito, nagipasagdan silang mga pamilya, they are taking care of them. And so many of them are actually found in the streets, and they adopted them. And doing so, dirty things like basically cleaning their mess. Imagine for that. These sisters, in fact, when you see their habit, the habit is what they wear. It's the cheapest of all the garments. Compared to us. But themselves, the sisters, completely practice works of charity, especially towards those who are considered as the outcast in the society. Why is it that? Why is that so? I think, sisters or dear children, my dear Benedictines, Mother Teresa has this or had this dictum. Look at the eyes of each and every one as Jesus lives in them. That even the lowliest of all, those who are abandoned because they look like nothing for others, Jesus lives in them. Jesus is in them. So I think it's easier for us as well, no? Especially, no, we cannot please everyone. Siguro, some of you may have enemies. Ngayon mo po, ang kay Jesus silang now, Father, eh, kumakita mo, okay? Dawak, ignaw. Pinag-ibakira. I think it's really a challenge that for Saint Mother Teresa, the lowliest of them all, or out of the lowliest in our eyes, still Jesus in them. And for us, the lowliest could be even our enemies because we don't want to see them. We don't want to be with them. But Jesus is in them. And of course, you heard that, especially for the fourth year, grade 10, you know, you called yourselves as the class of St. Aloysius Gonzaga. You know what I read about his life? For some of us, or I think most of us, the moment we know how to speak, what are the first words that we learn to speak? Papa, mama. Karambono, iPhone. The first words that Saint Aloysius Gonzaga learned when she was still even a baby was, or were, imagine, Jesus, Mary. Isn't it extraordinary? And those words were the ones who guided him until he grew. And of course, he became a Jesuit. And you know what? What's interesting is the last word he spoke when he died at the age of 32 were the same words that he first learned to speak. Jesus, Mary. Imagine that. So I think these two holy persons that we remember today give us simply a good example. The words that we speak, are they expression of who Jesus is? Or they're like curses, negative vibes? whatsoever. And how do we see each and every one? Do we see Jesus in them, or I don't know. Today's gospel gives us another example of what Jesus wants us to do. To always think of the welfare of others. More than the law is our welfare. And I think Mother Teresa could help us in that regard. More than following basic, especially, all your teachers knows the meaning about this. Dura lex said, lex, the law may be harsh, but it is the law. To the point that we tend to do good things because it's the law, without any more putting heart to the law. It's like, for instance, or in your vehicle, you're in your car, and then a beggar would come in, tap, tap, tap. Eh, bawal, muhatag sa kalsada. But I think, you're becoming very simplistic and rigid. For Mother Teresa, she said, it is better to commit mistakes in giving than never give at all. Problema na nila, kung nangilag sila, basta kita, nakahatag ta. Manami kita lang sa manubag ng katapusan sa kalibutan. So as we continue in this Eucharistic celebration, you, my dear students, especially you, grade 10, you maybe are very comfortable in your respective homes. Of course, having classes online, in your cozy homes, with your fast internet service provider. But I think also of others who have nothing, but even the basic of what we have. Because Jesus lives in each one of them, even most daily in our eyes. Let's now offer our intentions. Inspired by the guidance of Christ, let us now bring our needs to the God of all mercies. So in every petition, let us say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that the Holy Spirit inspires us to live by what is truly important in our lives, and we will not be blinded by riches, fame, or pride. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that those who suffer abuse and indignity for the Lord may be bestowed with grace and courage to continue in the mission of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that in our daily lives, through our behavior and example, we ourselves should not be an obstacle to others in finding the path to salvation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the end of hatred, intolerance, and discrimination in the world, and that all people, irrespective of race, color, or creed, be recognized as being equal in the eyes of our Almighty Father and Creator. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our schools, that they be havens of learning and safety for our children, particularly at this time when so many are fearsome of the spread of COVID-19. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the LC12 St. Aloysius Gonzaga students may prioritize the words of God in their lives, and that they may get out from their comfort zone to sow love, compassion, harmony, and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for our loved ones who went ahead of us, especially Ms. Lydia C. Ibanez, Attorney Francis M. Zosa, the SBCEC faculty and staff, and all our departed brothers and sisters, that our Lord will grant them the happiness that He had promised. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We bow our heads and remember in silence our personal intentions and the intentions of those who have asked for our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord God, let every command of yours be to us an invitation to love and serve our brothers and sisters, like Mother Teresa of Calcutta did, to understand and to respect, to guide and to be guided. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Receive, O Lord, the offerings of your people, and grant that we who celebrate your Son's work of boundless charity may, by the example of Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta, be confirmed in love of you and of our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love. And that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example lends us courage. Their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim.
Oh,
Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving his thanks and praise, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took a chalice. Once more, giving thanks and praise, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, may they fill his auxiliary and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially those for whom we offer this Mass. And all those who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, especially the administration, the faculty and staff, the pupils, the students of the St. Benedict Childhood Education Center, their parents, their loved ones, and the collaborators. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta, and Saint Aloysius Gonzaga, all those who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Father, Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we who are renewed by these sacred mysteries may follow the example of Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta, who honored you with tireless devotion and by surpassing charity was of service to your people. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let's now pray the Oratio Imperata.
God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but ever deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen.
Saint Raphael, Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Rock,
pray for us.
Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta,
pray for us.
Saint Aloysius Gonzaga,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Canuso,
pray for us.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
For Benedictine life is patterned after the life of Saint Benedict, of course, right? And of course, it's a public knowledge that he is known for his dictum, Ora et Labora. In his works, and everything that he does or he did, everything is offered for the glory of God in his works and in his prayers. I think through Benedictine, it's also a challenge for you. Like Saint Aloysius, all the words that we speak should manifest about Jesus. And all, in all the people that we see, we should always see Jesus, though others don't look like Jesus at all. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is offered. Go in the peace and the love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.
you and good afternoon, everyone. Keep safe. Shout out to your parents.
Thank you, Father.